Welcome back to Projects in Dad's Garage. It's been a while since I made a video. Had some things going on that kind of prevented me from getting out here and doing much, but we are doing some things now. Got a couple things going on. Got in back in April a blue LDO switch wire frame. So we're going to be changing the switch wire from the black frame to that blue frame. We're gonna change the printed parts colors as well. So we've got, I don't know how well this will come across on video here. Well, let me grab this. From West 3D, it's their titanium anode filament. It's a lovely color change, shifting green, blue, purple filament. It's an ASA. And then Inland Glitter Orange ABS, which I think is actually Polymaker's orange ABS. I think Polymaker's making that for Micro Center. So we're going to be switching to that. I don't know if I'm going to reprint the Enrage Rabbit Carrot Feeder. I'm not a huge fan of the color of it, but it's also a pain in the butt. So I don't know. But then we've also got a couple other things in. So we've got stepper motor because the switch wire we're going to be putting standard size steppers on rather than the short ones. Got from West 3D, their Undertaker nozzle, tungsten carbide. It's a really cute little case they 3D print for this. And that's going to go on the Trident. Then we've got parts to make a Ajax 3D TD1 kit. We're going to mess around with some of Q-Forge. Got another roll of this titanium anodized filament. And then we've got the stuff to make a little belt tensioner gauge. So we got some fun stuff there. Now, I have a filament dryer. It's this fixed dry, and it works okay. But that West 3D titanium anode filament was a pain in the butt to dry. So kind of brought to light I might need another dryer. And the filaments that I have sitting around here, I've been sitting here for quite some time. Some of them have been here for over 2 years now. They're vacuum sealed and whatnot, but it's still a garage. So over time, things get wet. So we've got one of these new-ish. It was coming out right around the last time I did much with 3D printing back in the spring. Sunlu S4 filament dryer. Plan is to put this over here between flip-flop the V0 and the Trident, and then this will go in between them, and then I can print out of this into either one of those. And that fixed dry I can use on the 2.4 maybe. Anyway, so. We've got stuffs. Oh, the off-gassing. Got, little plugs and stuff for there. Flip this around. Let's grab an extension cord, get rid of this box. And just make sure this thing works. Attachable cord, power button. My camera stopped following me. What are you doing? I'm over here. Hello. Hello? Hey, there you are. All right. So, detachable power cord, power button on the front. Nice. Got some fans in there. Circulate the air. Maybe place to put some desiccant packets, I guess. That is fantastic. That'll be nice. That works. So, what else do we have going on? Last I saw you guys was for a live stream for the 2.4 working on tap changer, stealth changer. That is exactly where left off on that. Nothing's happened with that scent. Nothing's happened with anything really since. Box Turtle is supposed to be released here, shipping at the end of the year, beginning of next year. So we'll see about maybe doing one of those for the Trident. Tap changer on the 2.4, rebuild on the switch wire. All the old switch wire parts are going to go to my son for him to build himself a switch wire. And we'll go from there. We've got a couple of things we need to fix. The 2.4, the LGX extruder stepper motor seems to be dying. So I've got some stepper motors from getting them for the tap changer. We're going to throw one of those on there. Let's see how those work. They're Seaborg stepper motors. Hopefully they're the same pinion size. I'm not sure. I think they're 10 tooth pinions, so I hope that the one in the LGX is as well. And then gonna put some auxiliary fans in the V0. because whenever printing on the V0, you're going to print small things with small low layer times. So a little bit of auxiliary cooling go a long way on that. Maybe we'll change out the tool head from the mini stealth burner over to the dragon burner. We'll see. I got a couple projects. Got a couple projects coming up. Like I said, we're gonna mess around with some Hue Forge stuff. We'll see where it goes. But stay tuned for some videos and hope to see you guys soon.